You are back with Anton for the West Ham Daily Transfer Show on a day that West Ham finally announced the director of football has finally taken his place in a job. David Sullivan has finally followed through with one of his promises that he made to the West Ham fans later last season. And yes, we have now got the man they know as Mario Husilos. I can't pronounce his name. I'm terrible with name pronunciations of some names. So yeah, he joins West Ham as director of football, hopefully putting David Sullivan all the way back into his mansion and having no involvement with team selections or transfer selections moving forward, which for me is a positive. What do we know on Mario Husilos? He's a former footballer and he has had a decent career over over many years, scoring some goals. He's Argentinian. He's worked alongside Pellegrini when he was at Malaga, and then they had a very successful 2012-13 season where Malaga actually finished sixth in La Liga and they reached the quarterfinals of the Champions League in the Copa del Rey. Pellegrini's been wanting this man in place for a while, so I'm just glad we could finally get this over the line. Husilos was recently at Malaga. Unfortunately, they got relegated last season and he left Malaga last week. So now the deal has been put in. West Ham have announced it. And hopefully he can come in and offer some much needed support in the transfer dealings for West Ham. And hopefully we can get some more deals over the line. So all in all, it's a positive appointment by West Ham. Let's hope, like I said at the start, that David Sullivan can finally just go back into his really small seat that he has back in his mansion and just kind of stop getting involved. And maybe this can also have an impact on some of the leaks that come out in the media, which is something that, you know, depending on what kind of fan you are, do you like it, do you not? Sometimes I feel like the leaks are not that great. As a West Ham fan, we don't need that that media attention. But anyway, it's onwards and upwards, which is a great appointment. So moving on to the next story is West Ham are advanced talks with Fabianski of Swansea City, who were relegated last season. Fabianski is 33 years old, goalkeeper, Polish international, and currently is fighting for a starting place for Poland in the World Cup that starts tomorrow. So would this be a great signing? What would this do for West Ham? You know, West Ham position for a goalkeeper has been up for grabs pretty much for a few seasons now. West Ham are conceding goals left, right and centre over the last three seasons. There's some crazy statistics. I'll maybe get some of them out to you over the next couple of videos, but we need to tighten up that area, the defensive area, the goalkeeping area. Try and get in a number one. Is Fabianski a number one? You may ask me. In hindsight, I would say he's not. No, I don't believe he is a number one. Although since we have been linked to him, I've dug a little bit deeper into his stats. I've dug a little bit deeper into seeing what Swansea fans are saying, and it looks like they're going to be massively disappointed to lose this player. And the reasoning behind losing this disappointment over him is, out of the 180 plus games he has played for Swansea, he's only made 13 errors that lead to goals, that have led to goals. Those statistics are massive, and even more so when you put them in conjunction alongside Joe Hart's and Adrian's mistakes since they have both joined our club. Maybe that could be the progression and, you know, the step forward that West Ham have been looking for. I'm not saying he's the goalkeeper I want for a long time, but is it a step forward? In my opinion, it possibly is. He's got over 220 appearances in the Premier League, covering from Arsenal and from Swansea City. So he's been around. He is 33. He's potentially available for £7 million, and the rumour is he's in advanced discussions with West Ham over a move. I do know West Ham would be keen to get this move completed before the World Cup starts, you know, if he is catapulted into the number one position, which it's looking potentially likely he may be, then that could also increase the value of the player. I do believe they'll be keen to get this deal done. And for me, he's a commanding goalkeeper. Like I said, I wasn't a great fan. There's potentially some other goalkeepers around. You could look around some of the other teams lower down. You could look at players like Foster, You know, you've even got the old geezer, Buffon, kicking about. You know, don't know if that's me just throwing out a big name just for the sake of it, but hey ho, he's there, he's available, and it'd be interesting just to see what happens. But Fabianski looks like it's going to happen. What impact will that have on Adrian? Probably a big one. He's loyal to the club, but he wants to be number one. He has stated he wants to be number one. I don't see West Ham paying £7 million for Fabianski with the statistics I've just read out to you and not putting him in the number one spot. To be fair, there needs to be changes within our squad, and sometimes you need to take the positives with the negatives, and we might be saying goodbye to Adrian. Finally, another player we are linked with is also another Swansea City player, and his name's Alfie Mawson. Alfie Mawson is a young English defender, centre-half, that's been playing for Swansea. He is 6'2". He's got a big frame. He's a very physical centre-half. He is commanding at the back, another thing that we miss, another thing that we need. Even more so now, the fact that Winston Reid has been a lot more injury prone. I'm a massive, massive fan of Winston Reid, but I can see the progression in signing a young English defender like Alfie Mawson. And if he is available for the £20 million, it could be a steal in today's transfer market, considering they have been relegated, Swansea City, and that allows us to be able to get that quality of player for maybe a better price. A lot of the top teams are probably sniffing around them, so in order to get this deal done, we'd probably just need to get in and get about it and get it. You know, I think he would come to West Ham. I could see him coming to West Ham and enjoying his time there. He's played a lot in the lower leagues of the English football, so he's a seasoned pro in the lower leagues of all of the English football. What I like about him is he's got a great range of long distance passing. And he can switch the play from left to right very easy, and that's something that, coming from previously me being a defender, you know, that's something that you always look to do. Is you can look up, you can read the game, and you can find a pass from distance. We always have these players like Obonna sometimes try it. I just feel like he lumps the ball up sometimes in a long ball hope style. Let's hope the ball lands in front of a player. Where Alfie Mawson, I've seen some of the clips and watched some of the games, and it looks like he can pinpoint a pass to a relevant player, or you can see a run that they're making, and that's something that we could only benefit from moving forward. His height, he's tall, he gives him an edge over the opposition, and he's an aerial threat, and he kind of nips up and scores some goals, and has scored some goals from Swansea from set pieces, so that's always a positive as well. He looks like a perfect Premier League defender. An old school Premier League defender, and I like those kind of defenders, you know, someone that can read the game really well, strong, effective, and throws his body in the line of fire, which is something that we've loved looking over James Collins' career. And even more so, going further back, James Tompkins, he used to throw himself on the line, throw himself in front of the balls, put himself into challenges, etc. I'm quite excited about this signing. His weaknesses is he looks like he's a little bit laid back when he gets the ball, but that's, you know, youth style football, and maybe Pellegrini and the coaching staff can help make or progress Alfie Mawson's style in the Premier League. But you know, for to potentially bring in these two players for a combined fee of £27 million, do they make a positive impact on our squad, and do they progress our squad to a higher standard? In my opinion, yes. Fabianski is not my first choice. Will I back him? Yes. Can I see the reason why we want to sign him? Yes. Those stats read for themselves. Alfie Mawson, bring that youthfulness into our defence. He's got a strong career in the Premier League. He has got some experience in there. And then obviously the appointment of the director of football. So all good news, fantastic, short, sharp, effective video. Make sure you subscribe to our channel, make sure you put the comments in, make sure you like, and make sure you hit the notification so you know when our videos are coming up. There'll be a new one video coming up over the next couple of days, as long as there are some West Ham updates. I'm Anton, this is Ange United. Come on, you Irons.